Before we jump into the job display page, we forgot to do responsive design for this page. So let's just resolve that problem and then we'll continue. So let's have a look at the responsive design on this page. So 1200, looking good. I can see some padding here. Lovely stuff. What about 992? Still looking okay. Still looking okay. These inputs are becoming a little bit small, but this card is fine. So is this card. 768? Okay. Clearly this design doesn't work. So what we'll say is beneath 992, which I'm going to click on now, please do the same. And below 992, why don't we push the sponsored post to the bottom of the page, just above the footer. And as I said, realistically, you would be using pagination or some means to display less results on page load. So that sponsored post would get seen as a person scrolls to the bottom of the page. So let's do this. So currently we have our row container, and what we'll do is we're going to click on group sponsored post. On the conditional tab, we'll say that when the page width, page current page width is less than 992, so 991 or below. Let's change the width to 100%. So that is forced down to its next row. And let's do the same. Let's also copy this. I'm going to say copy special, copy conditional expressions. And then on the group content, let's right click, paste special, paste conditional expressions. So at 991, both want to occupy their 100% available space. And this one will get pushed beneath. Okay, so let's pull the handle down. And there we go. There it is down there. Now we need some space, okay? So I'm going to bring up the, let's use the elements tree here. So we have the group container, group content. Need to just get behind this group, show first parent. Ah, there we go. So we had column gap 48, let's add some row gap of 32. There we go, nice and neat. So down at mobile phone width, we can see that the sponsored post is separated from this job post. So now what we have to do is remain at 375 and then click on group inputs, because we need to do the same thing here, group inputs. So on each of these inputs, I'm going to say right click and paste special, paste conditional expressions, and we can see it starting to take shape. If you no longer have that in your memory and your clipboard, you can go to the group sponsored, right click, copy special, and copy conditional expressions. Now I'm just going to go through each one and say paste special, paste conditional expressions, another one, paste conditional expressions, and we do want this to be edge to edge as well, paste conditional expressions. We have a hidden button as well, don't we? So what we need to do is I've enabled the visibility on the group reset, which has then shown the group buttons. So it's the group buttons group that we paste conditional expressions. And also, lastly, on the reset button as well. Okay, looking good, guys. How else can we improve this? And let's also do the footer in this lesson. So what I want to do is make sure that this text shrinks down at a certain width as well. I've just noticed that we have some min width and min height, which I'm going to remove both. Then I'm going to head over to the appearance tab and I'm going to edit the style of heading 2. So we're going to set this at the style level and not at the element level, just because I want this text H2, wherever it is used in this app, I want it to become smaller below 992, across the app, nice and consistent, done from one location and editable from one location. So conditions tab, make sure that heading 2 is engaged. We'll say current page width smaller than, and then select all other breakpoints, find your 992, which is your tablet. Then I'm going to say font size, currently 60. We're going to drop this down to 48. Okay. And I think all the other settings will do. Let's have a look. Head over to the responsive tab and look at that, guys. Far, far better for responsive design. Now, in terms of this group section, we need less padding on the top and on the sides, because this is padding that is relevant for a larger screen. So in my responsive view, I'm going to double click group section. I'm going to head down. Right, okay, I can see a small problem. I've overridden the style. What we need to do is this, detach the style. Let's create a style for a group section, okay? So I've detached the style. Now I'm going to create a new style. I'm going to call this a section. Section. So we have card large, card medium, group border, section, and standard group. Okay. So a section will always have 96 in the top and bottom, 32 left and right. Let's now edit the style of the section. And on the conditions tab, we'll say page width smaller than sign. Now select your tablet 992 breakpoint. And I'm going to type pad for padding top, pad for padding bottom. And then I'm also going to do the left, right, and then set the values afterwards. So currently the padding top and bottom are 96. So below 992, I'd like them to be 64. Smaller screen, more real estate. Same with the left-right padding. Instead of 32, we're going to make them 16 and 16. Once you've done that, let's jump back into the responsive tab. And look at that. Far, far more relevant for a phone. Okay, let's do the footer, and then we'll finish this lesson up. I'm going to edit the element. Because it's a reusable element, we need to be clicking this button. Now on the responsive tab, click on 992. And actually 992 looks fine. I suspect 768 would look fine. 375 is a problem. Okay. So I'm not sure if I've lost my breakpoint, but I'm sure I used to have a 576 here. There it is there, 576. Okay. Might have to re-add this. Add custom, 576. You do the same if you don't see 576, because it's beneath the 576 breakpoint. I can see two now. So this is a bit of a bug, guys. I apologize if it's being a bit buggy for you. There's 576. So it's beneath 576 where it starts to become problematic. Remember, we could have more links in here, okay? And actually, what we need to do here is far simpler. It's in this group container that we need to head over to the layout tab and just add some gap spacing. It's going to be on the row gap. Let's add 24. And that solves that problem. But what about this spacing here? We don't have a style for this because this is a border with a unique color. So what we'll do is just add these changes conditionally. And the top button will still remain 48, that's fine, but I want 16 left and right. So again, page width, less than, let's choose 992. So it's the same as the other design work we've done. I'm going to look for pad left and padding right and change both to 16. Okay, we still have this sort of little problem here. And to fix that, back in this group container, we just need some column gap of 24. I wouldn't normally do this, but I suspected that that problem might exist. Sort of an arbitrary width. Anyway, guys, that is done. I'm going to head back to the search page. Responsive design. Head down to 768. Yeah, looking really good. Okay, so as you can see, we do have to add our breakpoints, but for the most part, the way we're designing is responsive within its nature, meaning that we're setting up our rows and columns, our padding, our gap spacing, all of that we're preparing for this end stage where we don't have to fight or tussle and guess the responsive design. We know that we have a breakpoint. It's 992 or it's 768 or it's 576. And at that stage, consistently throughout the app, we'll probably be changing the design. So there is a process, and try not veer from that process. Try design the way you've learned to with this course, which is consistently throughout the app, using consistent breakpoints to then apply these conditional changes. Okay, guys, finally, we can jump into the next part of the section, which is designing the job display page. So I'll see you in the next lesson.